नमस्कार विद्यार्थी मित्रांनो, मी कुशारे सर, श्री ज्ञानसागर कोचिंग क्लासेस पिंपळापासून। मित्रांनो, यूट्यूब चॅनल जर सबस्क्राइब केलं नसेल तर जरूर सबस्क्राइब करा। आज आपण मैथमेटिक्स पार्ट टू मधील पहिले चैप्टर जे सिमिलॅरिटी आहे त्यातील प्रैक्टिस सेट 1.1 घेऊया। विद्यार्थी मित्रांनो, आपण या अगोदरच तीन प्रॉपर्टी आहेत, त्या तीन प्रॉपर्टीचा आपल्याला इथे यूज करायचा। नाउ द फर्स्ट एग्जांपल ऑफ द प्रैक्टिस सेट 1.1 इज बेस ऑफ अ ट्रायंगल इज 9 एंड इट्स हाइट इज 5, बेस ऑफ अनदर ट्रायंगल इज 10 एंड हाइट इज 6, फाइंड द रेशियो ऑफ एरियाज ऑफ दीज ट्रायंगल्स। स्टूडेंट्स, व्हेन वी ऑब्जर्व देयर आर टू ट्रायंगल्स हुज बेस एंड हाइट इज गिवन, सो लेट्स कंसीडर दैट दीज टू ट्रायंगल्स हैविंग बेस, हाइट एंड एरिया सच एज लेट बेस, हाइट एंड एरिया ऑफ फर्स्ट ट्रायंगल इज बेस B1, हाइट H1 एंड एरिया इज A1। ऑल्सो बेस, हाइट एंड एरिया ऑफ सेकंड ट्रायंगल इज B2, H2 एंड A2 रिस्पेक्टिवली। ओके, बाय यूजिंग दिस स्टूडेंट हियर the base of the first triangle is 9, so that we take here B1 is equals to 9, height is 5, mean that H1 is equals to 5. Also for the second triangle, the base is 10, mean that B2 is equals to 10 and the height is 6, mean that H2 is equals to 6. And the question is asked that find the ratio of areas of these two triangles, mean that we have to find here A1 as to A2 is equals to question marks. Now for this, we know that the property. Here, when you observe here, base and height is given, so that we use the first property. First, you have to write this property. The property is that. Now, the property is the ratio of areas of two triangles is equal to the ratio of the products of their bases and corresponding heights. So by using this property, we have to write shortly, this one is A1 upon A2 is equals to the ratio of the product of their base and corresponding heights, mean that B1 into H1 upon B2 into S2. Then we substitute the values. The value of B1 and H1 is given here. Therefore, I have to write here A1 upon A2 is equals to the value of B1 is 9 into H1 is 5 upon B2 is 10 and H2 is 6. When we substitute, if we looking these values, we can simplify it by using the Simplification. This one is 5 1 is 5, 5 2 is 10. Then 3 3 is 9, 3 2 is 6. Then we cannot again simplify it. So that the ratio of area in that A1 upon A2 is equal to 3 1 is 3 upon 2 2 is 4. Mean that A1 as to A2 is equal to 3 as to 4. Now you have to write the answer in full sentence always. Therefore, the answer is the ratio of areas of two triangles is 3 as to 4. Can you understand the first example? Okay. Student, second example. In this figure, BC is perpendicular to AB and AD is perpendicular to AB. BC is given, BC is 4 and AD is how much? 8. We have to find here the ratio of areas of these two triangles, mean that ABC upon area of triangle AD. First, when we observe this figure, for this two triangles, the base AB is equal. Mean that for these two triangles, base is equal. If the base is equal, then by using the property, their area is equal to the ratio of their corresponding heights. So that in this, we write here in triangle ABC and triangle ADB, the base AB is equal. AB is equal. Here is given that BC is equal to 4, AD is equal to 8, and find out here area of triangle ABC upon area of triangle ADB is equal to how much? We know that the property, the ratio of areas of two triangles with equal base is equal to the ratio of their corresponding heights. So that by using this property, this area, mean that area of triangle ABC upon area of triangle ADB is equal to the ratio of their corresponding height, mean that the height is, the first triangle ABC having height is BC and for second angle height is AD. Then we substitute the values. Therefore, area of triangle ABC upon area of triangle ADB is equal to value of BC is 4, value of AD is 8. Student, we can simplify it. The simplification is 4 1 is 4, 4 2 is 8. Therefore, area of triangle ABC upon area of triangle ADB is equal to how much? 1 upon 2. Therefore, the ratio of these two triangles is equal to 1 upon 2. Can you understand second example? Okay, question number 3. In this figure, PS is perpendicular to RQ. Segment QT is perpendicular on PR. And RQ is equal to 6. PS is equal to also 6. And the value of PR is 12. Now, we have to find out QT. For finding out the value of QT, student, first we find out the area of the triangle PQR. For We know that the formula for area of rectangle. Now here is given is that RQ is equals to 6, PS is equals to also 6, PR is equals to 12. We have to find out the value of QT. It's question now. Now here area of triangle is equals to half into base into height. This is the formula for area of triangle. Now here is area of triangle PQR is equals to half into this base is QR, that is RQ, and the height of that triangle is PS. We substitute the values. Half into RQ is how much? 6, and PS is also 6. We can simplify it. 2 1s are 2, 2 3s are 6. Student, 3 into 6 becomes 18. Now, therefore, area of triangle PQR is equals to 18 unit is square unit. Suppose that this is equation number first. Student, here is unit is not given, so we can take unit. Now, again by using this area, we can find out the value of this QT. Such way that also area of triangle PQR is equals to half into the base we have to take as PR. At that time their corresponding height is QT. Now then we substitute the value. From the equation first we have to substitute the value of area of triangle PQR is 18. Then the value of PR is 12. We have to find out the value of QT. QT as it is. Here you write from equation first. Now student, you have to transpose all these values first to this side, or else you have to simplify by using 2 to 12. But I have to take all these values to this another side. Then it convert as denominator convert into numerator. Means that 2 goes to numerator and this 12 is here in the position of numerator, goes to denominator, is equals to how much? QT. Student, when we divide this, 2 1s are 2, 2 6 are 12, then 6 1s are 6, 6 3s are 18. Mean that 3 is equals to QT, means QT is equals to 3. We write the answer in full sentence. Therefore, the value of QT is equals to 3. Can you understand the third example also? Okay. Question number 4. Observe this figure. In this figure, AP is perpendicular on BC. AD is parallel to BC. Then find out area of triangle ABC as to area of triangle BC. Now, when you observe this, students, these two triangles are in between two parallel lines, AD and BC. All of you know that the distance between any two parallel line is constant. So that the height of both these triangles are equal. So, first triangle its height is AP, means that this distance is constant, so the height of the second triangle is also same, means that AP. Now students, we take this height, solution is, here segment AD is parallel with segment BC. These two lines are parallel. We know the distance between any parallel line like this. E is constant. Again, like this, constant. Therefore, the heights of triangle ABC and triangle BCD is equal. Also, when we look this, the base of these two triangles, base of triangle ABC and triangle BCD is also equal. That is, segment BC is equal. Now, here is height is also equal and base is also equal. Therefore, by using the property, if the height is equal and base is equal, then their ratio is also equal. Therefore, the triangles having equal base and equal heights, therefore their areas also equal. Therefore, area of triangle ABC is equals to area of triangle BCD. Now, when we transpose this BCD to this side, then we get area of triangle ABC upon this transpose here, means that area of triangle BCD is equals to, here is the constant of this area of triangle is 1, means that 1. And the coefficient of this one is also 1, transpose to another side is 1. Means that the ratio of areas of two triangles is equals to 1 upon 1. Then the answer in full sentence is that, therefore, area of triangle ABC is area of triangle BCD is equals to 1 as to 1. Can you understand this fourth example? So simple. Okay. The last question of the practice set 1.1. When we observe this figure, there are four sub questions for the last question. Now, first we take the first sub question. Solution of this first one is, now here we have to find out ratio of areas of these two triangles. Now, when you observe here, area of triangle PQB, look at PQB, this triangle, then PBC, mean that PBC. Now when we observe this, in triangle PQB, the base is BQ and height is BQ. And in triangle PBC, the base is BC and height is PQ. Means for both these two triangles, the height is equal. So by using this property, so here is for triangle PQB and triangle PBC, the height is equal. Then by using the property is the ratio of areas of two triangles with equal height is equal to the ratio of their corresponding bases. Therefore, area of triangle PQ एरिया ऑफ ट्रायंगल पीबीसी इज इक्वल्स टू, नाउ स्टूडेंट PQ इज द हाइट फॉर बोथ दिस ट्रायंगल. नाउ देयर करस्पोंडिंग बेसिस फॉर द फर्स्ट ट्रायंगल, द बेस ऑफ PQB इज BQ एंड द बेस ऑफ द ट्रायंगल PBC इज BC. Therefore, the answer of the first one is the ratio of areas of triangle PQB upon area of triangle PBC is equals to BQ upon BC. This is our first property. Now, then we discuss about the second property. Now, the second property is area of triangle PBC upon area of triangle ABC. Now, for the second, when you observe these two triangles, PBC, PBC, the base is BC and height is BQ. And ABC, for triangle ABC, base is AB, BC and height is AB. Now, when you observe here, for both these triangles, the base is equal. We know that if the base is equal, then their ratio is equal to their corresponding heights by using this property. Therefore, in triangle PBC and triangle ABC, the base BC is equal. If the base is equal, then the ratio of areas of two triangle is two triangle with equal base is equal to the ratio of their corresponding height. So that by using this property, this ratio means that area of triangle PBC upon area of triangle ABC is equals to their corresponding height. PBC having height is PQ and ABC, triangle ABC having height is ED. This is the second ratio, mean that area of triangle PBC upon area of triangle ABC is equals to PQ upon AD. Now, then we take the third ratio. The third ratio is area of triangle ABC upon area of triangle ABC. Now, look at the figure. In triangle ABC, base is BC, height is AD. And for triangle ADC, base is BC and height is AD. So that, in these two triangles, which is the common? The height is the common. So, for triangle ABC and triangle ADC, the height AD is equal. So that by using the property, the ratio of areas of two triangles with equal height is equal to the ratio of their corresponding bases. So that the area of triangle ABC upon area of triangle ADC is equal to, here is height is equal, then their corresponding bases for triangle ABC, the base is BC, and for triangle ADC, the base is DC. This is our third ratio. Area of triangle ABC upon area of triangle ADC is equals to BC upon DC. Now, then the last ratio. The ratio is that. Fourth ratio is area of triangle ADC upon area of triangle PQC. This is our fourth ratio. Area of triangle ADC upon area of triangle PQC is equals to question. Now student, observe in figure. ADC, base is BC, height is AD, and for triangle PQC, base is QC and height is PQ. Now, when we observe these two triangles, there is height and base are different. So that by using the property, first property, the ratio of areas of these two triangles is equal to the ratio of the product of their bases and corresponding height. So that for these two triangles, we write the property, the ratio of areas of two triangles is equal to the ratio of the products of their bases and corresponding heights. By using this property, we write here, therefore area of triangle ADC upon area of triangle PQC is equal to the ratio of the product of their base and corresponding height. So that for the triangle ADC, the base is DC and the corresponding height is AD. And for triangle PQC, the base is QC and their corresponding height is PQ. This is our fourth point. The ratio of areas of two triangles is equal to the ratio of the product of their base and corresponding heights. Now student, we write the answer in full sentence. So, all ratios are. The answer in full sentence. Answer. First one is, area of triangle PQB upon area of triangle PBC is equal to. What is the answer? Now, when we look this, PQB, the base is BQ, height is PQ. PBC, base is BC and height is PQ. Means that height is equal. So that their ratio is equal to their corresponding bases. Means that BQ upon PBC is a base color on DC. Then, second one is, area of triangle PBC upon area of triangle ABC. When you look this, area of triangle PBC, base is BC, height is PQ. And for triangle ABC, base is BC, height is AD. So that their ratio is equal to their corresponding heights, mean that PQ upon parallel AD. Third one is, answer of the third one is area of triangle ABC upon area of triangle ADC is equal to. Look here, ABC and for ADC. Now for these two triangles, height is equal. Then the ratio is equal to their corresponding bases. Mean that ABC is a base jhala kai BC. And ADC is a base jhala kai BC. Then the last answer is that. The fourth one is area of triangle ADC upon area of triangle PQC. When you observe these two triangles ADC and PQC, the ratio is equal to their product of base and corresponding heights. Mean that the base of ADC is DC. into corresponding height is AD, and the base of the PQC is QC, and corresponding height is PQ. This is our answer in full sentence. Now, student, can you understand the practice set 1.1? If any doubt, then you can also ask me. Okay, thank you very much.